One of the measures that passed was a resolution urging the state to adopt rules regarding manta ray dive sites off the Big Island. We wanted to know what the state plans to do to protect our ocean resources and, more importantly, people. Ron Mizutani has the answers in a story you'll see only on KHON2.
The majestic manta rays off Hawaii Island's Kona coast have become a major attraction for visitors and local residents.
So I've done the manta ray night dive several times myself, and I think it's a treasure that we have just in that area that people should definitely come and enjoy.
But that's part of the problem. The activity has boomed over the past 25 years.
In 1991, when we started doing it on a regular basis, it was one boat, maybe a couple times a week. By 1993, it had grown to four boats or five boats.
Keller Laros, a longtime manta ray advocate and researcher, says the number of operations has exploded.
Now, Ron, we regularly get over 15 boats, sometimes over 20 boats, literally 200 people in the water.
Just a few years ago, we had one diving operation. Now it's not uncommon to see 200 divers in the ocean. That is an accident waiting to happen.
Yes, I think so. I mean, we've heard reports of having more than 20 boats, and that's in addition to, you know, people who might swim in from shore, do a shore dive or kayak over, or now stand up paddle boards as well.
It's one of the reasons Representative Nicole Lowen, who represents the Kona District, introduced legislation that urges the DLNR to adopt rules to better manage specific dive sites.
The clock is ticking. What's the timetable on that? Because it's not a matter of if, but when an accident could happen. We're talking about not just our resources, but human beings.
True. And, you know, we already had the case where the captain left people in the water.
DLNR Director William Isla says the administrative rulemaking process, which includes public hearings, generally takes more than a year. He says this particular issue may involve two divisions of the DLNR. The number of boats anchored in an area falls under boating, and what's potentially happening to the mantas themselves falls under aquatic resources. But he agrees.
It's not a good situation to have that many people in the ocean at night.
Laros estimates 40 to 50,000 people are diving with manta rays off Kona every year, and something needs to be done soon.
Whatever's best for the environment, whatever's best for the manta rays, whatever's best for the industry needs to be done.
Before a manta is injured, or even worse, someone is killed. Ron Mizutani, KHON2 News.